We shouldn't have said that. So now we can't speak. We should take it back. Stop being so damn meek. But it was wrong. But we were right. Stop being a coward. We have the right to speak our mind. But we have to keep others feeling in sight. Do I have to remind? Who cares what other people think? They never had us in mind when they were being awful. That doesn't mean we ignore everything. We have to be watchful. No, I will not. Your solution for everything is to bottle it up, but that's wrong. You have made her feel as if there is nothing left to give. She waits for moments that never come so she can live. With you, she worries so much she can't remember the word happy. She forgets how to smile and honestly turns scrappy. And what about you? You're the one who is constantly pushing her to go through with things she doesn't want to do. Telling her to get up, stop being lazy, do better. You're the definition of condescending down to the very last letter. At least I make an effort for her to get up and do something. You always hold her back from everything. It isn't fair. This isn't fair. To hold her to standards they don't hold themselves. To have to conform to their expectations, to be looked at like a freak when she does something unique. I don't care if you think it is wrong. Giving up and giving in is not an option. It is better to move forward and find a solution. The only reason she has friends is because I told her to get out there. While you told her to stay because she was scared. I get you want to help her. I do too. But wallowing in her past pain isn't helping. That's why I push her to move forward so she knows she is capable of something. We can't allow people to get her down. She will lose every piece of happy she has ever found. Devoid of emotion, we will be left in the grave with nowhere to go and nowhere to stay. She will be lost, and with it a great cost. Every word has a price and every action a consequence. Do not mistake your words for being nice. Your words hurt her the most. This is a poem that I wrote called Self-Talk at 2 a.m. If you'd like to hear more of my poems that I have written or will write in the future, let me know and I'll make some more.